The closest thing you can find to actually riding a wave in the mountains is a gully. You're being pushed in two directions, just like on a wave, using the momentum that you create coming down the face to drive yourself back up the face. And you work your way as high up the face as you can until you reach that point where the peak of your turn is totally weightless. I think commonly people only understand progression as a physical act, somebody doing something with their body that no one's ever done before. But there's another kind of progression in snowboarding that allows maybe like a lower impact lifestyle or a more sustainable lifestyle. But that's what's great about this sport, is that you can define it however you'd like to, and it's totally open to interpretation. You're starting to see a lot more creativity with terrain and use of terrain, and more events like the Holy Bully and the Big Wave Challenge and tons of bank slaloms all over the world.
Avocado will make little interesting taste like a tuna as soon as you put the soy sauce on it. That's why that avocado was the kind of the replacement of the tuna, the fish hater.
I'd been feeling like I needed a change for a while, and I guess I was attracting that because the following season I met Rip at the Dirksen Derby. Before I knew it, I was in Seiko, riding all these different shapes and starting to understand a different way to interpret snowboarding. It only takes a couple days riding with the Gentem Stick crew to realize that they have a different outlook. For one, they're always riding insanely deep powder. And secondly, they're not focused on anything but turning and appreciating the feeling. It's a special feeling when you remember to stop thinking in the mountains and just let gravity tell you what to do. There's no end in sight when it comes to turning your board. It's something that you can do and enjoy for the rest of your life.